Hey, Gixxerman 01 back out in the garage today. We're going to talk about 3D printing. I just recently purchased a 3D printer for some projects out here in the garage, and I thought that I would kind of go over what I went through picking out a 3D printer. I got a little bit lucky in that one of the guys from work was getting into it at the same time, or actually he kind of prompted me into it. Listening to him talk about it, and so I started looking into it myself. It's something that I kind of wanted to do, but never was willing to take the leap into it. I didn't know really anything about it, and I got lucky. He kind of did all the hard work for me, looking through them and researching them, and kind of finding out what was the best one to get for a guy like me, a beginner. I mean, I don't know anything about Fusion 360 or CAD CAM or any of that kind of stuff. So if you think that 3D printing might be over your head, I'm going to tell you that it's probably not. It's just not that difficult. It's pretty easy. I mean, if you're going to design parts, that takes a little bit of brains, but there's a lot of stuff out there that's already done that you can go and download and run it through your slicer and print it yourself. So I'm just going to go over the 3D printer that I purchased, some of the things that I dealt with when I first started trying to print with it, and what I did to get it to print. So let's just get right to it. The printer I purchased is an Ender 3 version 2. It's not the absolute low-end entry level, but it's definitely the most popular entry level, not necessarily the version 2, but the Ender 3 is definitely out there in the 3D printing community, known as the best entry level 3D printer. There are tons of upgrades for them. So if you don't have the money up front, you can get started into an Ender 3 for about $200. You can pick up an Ender 3 Pro that has a couple upgrades to it for about $250, and then there's the version 2 that has even a few more upgrades, and you're looking around $300, and that's what this is. It's an Ender 3. A couple upgrades that I've made to it, a different extruder, just because I like the red anodizing. I bought the anodized leveling thumb screws. And then one of my first projects, I printed a couple red thumb nuts to go on the tensioners for the belts. There's a lot of tuning involved in getting this thing to print. One of the things that I found the most difficult getting started with it was just getting this level with the crossbar so that I wasn't having to tilt the bed to start with. Once I got this, what I felt like was as level as I could get it, then I started working on leveling the bed. And most 3D prints, there's a couple issues that you run into. One is your extruder height from the bed, you know, just getting that height correct. And then two, making sure that the bed is level. If you get those two things right, it usually goes pretty well. So the first issue I had was getting parts to stick to my bed. And I found a couple issues. One, this has a coating on it that when you heat it up, it gets a little bit sticky. So then the print sticks to it. And I wasn't heating my bed up enough. So the part would initially stick and then break free. So I ended up running this at 65 degrees Celsius. Seems to be my best setting for getting parts to stick. And while the instructions said not to do it, I did it anyway. I took a little isopropyl alcohol, a very small amount, just barely got a microfiber towel, just a little bit damp. And then the wet part of the microfiber towel, I took the glass bed off, and then I worked my way across, wiping the excess alcohol back off of the bed as I went across with a brand new clean microfiber towel. And that gave me a nice clean surface on my bed to get parts to stick. Again, that was the number one problem I had right out of the gate. Once I figured that out and I got parts to stick, then my print quality was really, really good. I did have one print that did some funny stuff, and then I figured out I had made these tensioner knobs and one of them I didn't get tight. So then the print head was a little jerky when it would start feeding back and forth across it. Once I tightened down the belt and started reprinting it, it printed great. So a lot of people have questions about 3D printing, and actually a few of you guys may have no idea how this works. So what you're doing is you're melting plastic filament rod in a print head here. And what it does is extrudes into layers until it builds up and makes a part. And you heard me say earlier that you load a 3D part into a slicer. And what the slicer is going to do, it's going to make it into layers so that it can tell this printer how to print it. And so you get, when you get an Ender 3, you'll get a barcode you scan that'll take you to their website, and you can download the Cura slicer software. And then probably my favorite website to go to get things to print is Thingiverse. The battery holders for my Milwaukee drill batteries, I printed the holders for the Shockwave containers from Milwaukee. I even printed a little holder to take the little ink saw markers from Milwaukee. So I have a selection of those hung up. So there's just a ton of stuff out there for you to print. And all that stuff was already, someone had already done all the work. You can make donations on that site to the people that have loaded those prints up so that they make a few coins for their effort. Or you can give them a shout out, telling them thank you. Some of them aren't set up to receive payments. So it's always nice to know that people are appreciative of your work. So at least give them a thumbs up, you know, or a thank you for downloading their project. So a couple things. A lot of people want to know what it costs. And so your initial investment in your 3D printer is anywhere from $200 to $300 for an Ender 3 or an Ender 3 Pro, or an Ender 3 V2. And then your next expense is going to be in filament. And so I've purchased all the same filament. I guess I'm a little OCD that way. I didn't want to have several different kinds of or different brands of filament. I started off with this Overture, and I've initially thought that maybe I picked the wrong one because I was having issues getting it to stick. But once I figured out my bed temperature, then that problem went away. So I have three colors, blue, red, and black. And you're looking at around $22 for a roll of this filament. And so a couple things about the filament. You wanna make sure that you store it someplace clean and dry. What I do is put it back in, and when I'm done printing something, I take that roll, I put it back into the bag, I take my shop back and suck the bag closed with a desiccant bag in with it that came with the filament. And then I seal that bag back up. I think that's probably the best way to store it. There's a couple people that make a dryer. You can buy a dryer for your filament. You can load your filament in there the day before you're gonna print, and it'll run like a dehumidifier to dry out your print filament. I haven't had any issues with any of that. I just put, like I said, I've been putting it back in a bag with a desiccant bag. This stuff is prone to that, drawing moisture. Nylon's probably the worst one for it. So I haven't printed any nylon yet, but if you're wanting to print something that's pretty strong, I'm gonna say nylon is probably the stronger of the plastics. So that's basically my intro into 3D printing. If you guys got specific questions that you want to know about 3D printing, it's a 110 volt, pretty simple. It takes a minute to put this together. There's a couple really good videos out there taking your time assembling this 3D printer will go a long way in getting you some very good prints. I watched one guy, his video to put this thing together. You tune it as you're assembling it. And so I think that went a long way with the fact that the quality of the prints that I've had have been really good. And I'm going to say that watching this guy's video, I'll put a link in the description, really helped me set my 3D printer up so that the quality of my prints are really good. I don't get a lot of stringers, and I don't have, all my layers are really smooth. I don't really have any jerky transitions in my layers. So really good prints so far. You're going to have some lines. That's just part of 3D printing. But overall, my prints have been really, really smooth, and I'm going to credit the setup video, the setup and assembly video that I watched and followed putting mine together. Went a long way in helping me start off probably a little further down the road than I would have had I tried to just figure this out on my own. But like I said, I'll put some links in the description. I'll put a link in the description. I bought all this stuff on Amazon, the filament, the printer, even the upgrades. I purchased all those on Amazon. Again, if you got any questions, shoot me a comment. Please click that like and subscribe button. We'll see you in the next video.